love when my dad saves me special treats he thinks I will like. I love when my mom lets me scratch my nose all over her shoulder, or when she will interrupt people to tell them that I am trying to finish my sentence.
What you just seen are some images of Ksenia Biskizadik, a Canadian jungler who suffers from brain disorder cerebral palsy. Although she has a particularly severe form of the disease, she can tend to her personal needs by herself and is now a 12th grader at a high school for normal students in Canada. That is thanks to the love and care of the whole family, especially her mother, Laverne Biskie. And actually, with Ksenia's example, Laverne is passing on the hope to a lot of families with children of CP in Vietnam. And for today's Expat Living, we invite you to join the No Ordinary Journey of Laverne Biskie and her team in Vietnam, starting at the Rehabilitation Hospital in Hue City. It's in the early morning, and these people are carrying their children to the Rehabilitation Hospital to meet a long-time friend. Laverne Biskie has come a long way from Canada to share the same struggle with people here, the struggle of dealing with cerebral palsy. Cerebral palsy is caused by an injury to the brain that usually happens during pregnancy or sometimes shortly after birth. CP affects people in different ways because different parts of the brain can be injured. However, it always has some impact on the person's movement, and this is because the messages coming from the brain to the muscle are affected. Of those with CP, 28% have epilepsy, 58% have difficulties with communication, and at least 42% have problems with their vision, and 23 to 56% have learning disabilities. For most parents, when they receive a diagnosis of cerebral palsy for their child, they experience confusion and strong emotions. Every parent searches for the best way of supporting their child.
For many of us, we dream that we will have a child, and we never even imagine that that child would have a disability or would have a problem. And so it's a huge, devastating shock when that happens. And I see that a lot of the Vietnamese parents are in that state of hopelessness. Their dreams have been shattered, and they haven't yet rediscovered a new dream.
Laverne's second child, Ksenia, was born 3 months prematurely. The doctor told her that her daughter had an 80% chance of having a disability because of the bleed in her brain. She was finally diagnosed with cerebral palsy. It became evident that she would be severely affected and would require a wheelchair for mobility for the rest of her life.
Even when we're in the situation where we can do something to make our child's life better, cerebral palsy is a condition that we can't change. You know, it can't be cured, it can't be healed, and so I think we share that pain whether we live in Vietnam or whether we live in Canada. We're always reminded that it's incurable and that there's only a certain amount that we can do, and that's hard.
Hi, my name is Rita.
Despite that, cerebral palsy kids are entirely capable of listening, understanding, and even going to school.
Hi, my name is Taylor.
Hi, my name is...
I move differently, but I need exercise like you.
I do things differently, but I move hands just like you.
The English term cerebral palsy is very neutral because it simply means brain and difficulty moving. But when I ask Vietnamese people about the terms that they use, the responses that I get are very disheartening. And I always think, if someone said that about my child, I would be so deeply hurt, because I know that's not true about her. And so it's extremely difficult when I hear Vietnamese people using that word, because it is not true of these children, and it perpetuates the myth that they can't learn and that they don't have a proper role in the family and that they shouldn't be socially included. So I think it's really important to change the name to cerebral palsy because of what the Vietnamese words represent.
As the couple became accustomed to having a child with a disability, Laverne began to see the silver lining and recognize the gift that disability might be. Following the passion for travel, the Bisky Zadik family have found a unique way to celebrate Ksenia's disability. It has led them to their version of an exceptional life.
This past summer, my family and I traveled to Vietnam for 6 weeks. That trip opened our eyes to the importance of simply having a family for children with cerebral palsy and other disabilities. When we were in Vietnam, I had my family around me, which was very helpful. I could not have done the trip without the support of my family. My family does these things because they love me and care about me.
This time in Vietnam, Ksenia can join the trip. Instead, Laverne travels with a team of doctors, nurses, social workers, and therapists of CP. She herself pays a visit to a local family in Hue City to meet Tao, a 3-year-old girl suffering from CP since birth.
You're such a big girl, almost 3. Can you come and sit with me? Do you want to come and sit with me? Yes, come and sit with me. Come and sit with me. Yes?
Thank you.
Go. Hi. How are you? Look at you. Such a cutie.
Trong quá trình mang thai đi khám thì bác sĩ cũng nói phát triển thai bình thường. Nhưng tới khi đi khám thì tới khi mà đẻ thì bị giảm nó thức phải mổ mà nói là nếu mà sinh ra cũng là đi mà để trong bụng đi.
This is a beautiful, beautiful little girl, and she is really the joy of those parents, but they need to let go of their fear about the future, their anxiety, their sense that they didn't do enough or they're not doing enough or they did something in the past that caused this. It's so much about mindset, and it's not related to the child's condition at all. It's completely related to the parent and how they feel about the situation. Oh. She looks just like my daughter when she does that.
You look just like Ksenia. You just look like Ksenia.
Except you know what Ksenia does? She goes, Mama? Do you want to go to Mama? You're so cute. Yes? It's okay. It's okay. Does she have a problem with constipation, or does she get a lot of colds, anything like that? And she's unable to stand. Does she sit by herself? No?
Hi! Hi!
Let me take you. Can you sit by yourself?
There you go. Oh, look how she sits. Yeah. There, and if you put a pillow in front, look at that.
It's good because it helps her to learn to sit and to hold her head up. But also then you don't have to hold her all the time.
Look at you. Look. Hold the head up. Heads up. Do you want to play with a spoon? See if you can grab that. Try this hand. Can you?
I think I really started to accept my child's condition when I began to experience the joy in my life of helping other people and being able to connect to other families. And I think when I could see that having a child with a disability caused me or encouraged me to do more for other people, that's when I began to feel some hope, and that's when I began to accept it.
This Vietnamese-American young man is also part of the team. Timulet took control of CP by being physically involved with sports. He is currently second degree black belt in Taekwondo.
When I do my kicks, I usually fall. But I fell a lot because when you have to bring your leg up high to hit the target, CP and spasticity, so my legs were tight. So I wasn't able to like reach as high as possible, but I tried my best and I overcame it by just doing my best and just put CP aside and just go for it, really.
Timmy is also a 2013 graduate from the Catholic University of America with a degree in biochemistry. He volunteers to go to Vietnam as an example of a CP patient.
I know what it's like having CP, and I want them to realize that even though there's a physical disability that affects them, their mind is just so incredible, and if they just have that mindset, they can just overcome the physicals.
Together with Timmy, Terry Gajinski had a late onset of CP. At the age of 5, he was hit on the head. His brain was damaged, and he suffered from CP ever since. Today he comes to Vietnam as a social worker, helping the patients to see the children's gifts and to connect to one another.
We associate how the brain, the ability of the brain is how they speak, but that's not necessarily true because people have great ability and not able to speak at times, and many children with CP are like that. So to change that belief that children with CP can't think or they're useless or they're not going to develop into anything is false. And that's part of using myself as an example to say, even if you have CP, there's a lot you could do for society, there's a lot you can contribute, and there may be damage to my brain, but there's also parts of my brain that work quite well. And that's the same for every child with CP.
Chen Chi Minh Chang, 22, is a model of overcoming challenges of CP. She volunteers to join the team in Hue City to give hope to the parents there.
If you watch her get into a vehicle or get out of a vehicle, she's had to work so hard to be able to do that with only a little bit of support. And so she's learned so many things on her own just by trying. But there's also something kind of sad about her that's very typical of children who have cerebral palsy. When Ksenia and I were here in Vietnam last time, we asked her what she liked to do. And she said, you know, I stay at home a lot, and I feel sad because I don't have enough people in my life. And I think what she was expressing was that loneliness and that state of isolation that a lot of people with disabilities live in because the world doesn't understand them. So even though she's accomplished an incredible amount, she can write, she's here independently by herself today, she still faces and she still lives with a lot of the really hard challenges, like being socially excluded.
On this two-week mission in Vietnam, Laverne's team has provided training to 100 families and 40 medical professionals on the management of cerebral palsy. They worked in four locations in Hue and driving promises and give dozens of wheelchairs to the CP patients. Above all, Laverne's inspiring story about traveling the world with Ksenia is the greatest inspiration to all. First accepting and then rising above the disability.
Bản thân chị là không phải là người Việt, nhưng mà chị cũng có một cái tấm lòng rất lớn là đã thương được các cái cháu bài nào ở đây cũng có cùng cái hoàn cảnh của con của chị, một cái sự đồng cảm mà đối với trẻ bài nào. Cái thứ hai nữa là nó cũng thể hiện được cái sự yêu thương, không phân biệt cái đất nước. Mặc dù là không cùng một dân tộc nhưng mà chị cũng đã biết chia sẻ cái khó khăn đó. Và qua cái tin chia sẻ đó thì chị cũng, một cái sự nỗ lực rất lớn của chị đó là chị đã kêu gọi các cái tổ chức và cá nhân hỗ trợ thêm cho các cái cháu bài nào ở đây nói chung và cái trẻ bài nào đang điều trị của bệnh viện chúng tôi.
The best thing that we can do when we're here is to give them hope, because it's with hope that they will create a new dream, and it won't be the same as the dream that they had originally. It'll be something new, and that I think would be the biggest gift that we could give them.
So I hope that the story of Laverne Bisky and her family's no ordinary journey has been able to move you, and it has moved me, and that people's awareness of cerebral palsy kids will be changed. Thank you very much, and goodbye for now.
Chiến thắng vang một nước, sung bài xa trên chiến khu, vì nhân dân chiến đấu không ngừng, hiến máu ra xa trường, tiến lên, cùng tiến lên, nước non Việt Nam ta, vững
bền.